Hey, what's going on everybody? It's your bro, hope you're doing well, and in this video I'm going to explain the return statement in Python, so sit back, relax, and enjoy the show.
If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running.
Alright people, let's begin. The return statement is used within functions to send Python values or objects back to the caller. These values or objects are known as the function's return value. So do you know how with functions we can pass arguments to a function, and then our function can do something with those arguments? Well, not only that, but our function can pass some value or object back to the caller. So what we'll do for this example is create a function that will simply multiply two numbers together and return the result back to the caller. So let's define a function called multiply, and we'll set up two parameters for this function. Let's say number one and number two. And what we'll do is say result equals number one times number two. And then at the end, we can return something. What do we want to return? Let's return whatever the result is. Now, when we call this function, we will pass in two values as arguments. Let's say we would like to multiply 6 times 8. So when we run this, while we can't actually see anything, when we return the result after multiplying numbers 1 and 2, it's going to return the result back to the caller. In order to see the value that is returned back to the caller, one way in which we can do this is to print the value that is returned within a print statement. So what we'll do is print the value that is returned after calling the multiply function. So 6 times 8 is really great. 6 times 8 is 48. Now, one other thing that we can do is store the returned value within a variable. So let's say x equals multiply 6 times 8, and then we will print whatever x is. So the result is still the same of 48. Now, with the return value, there is another way in which we could write this that uses less lines of code. So we'll delete this first line, and instead of returning a variable called result, what we'll do is just return number one times number two. And this would work the same as it does before, but it's written in less lines of code. So that's another way in which you could write this. All right, everybody, so that is the return statement. Functions can send Python values or objects back to the caller. These values or objects are known as the function's return value. You can either print this value directly to the console window, or you can store it within a variable or some other location. And well, ladies and gentlemen, that is how the return statement works in Python. Hey you, yeah I'm talking to you. If you learned something new, then help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.